So, hello everybody. I'm gonna try to, try to do the day 9 of Advent of Code right now. I tried it in the morning, like a few hours before, and I chose like algorithm or a way that I didn't really understand, so I think I'm gonna try something a bit different, and I think it's gonna work because I can kind of see in my head how that will work. And I have at least used finite state machines before, compared to the parsers, which are like new stuff for me. So let's see the input again, the puzzle. So we already have the file, but I'm gonna keep just some of it. So input is gonna be string, parse is gonna be the input. We will do nothing with it. Output will be integer. We cannot go any way around that. We can remove the parsers. So this almost worked. I didn't manage to get it to work, and let's not think about it again. So the Let's see, let's do the tests. So I will just create a macro to do a row, and then we can do like five rows, probably. One more. Yeah, and of course this broke the Vim macro. Now, let's do another macro for the just things, or maybe oops. Nope, that did not work. Okay, let's just do it by hand. And then 5, 9, and 9. Now let's copy the stuff inside. Let's uncomment these. So okay. So tests are done. Sequence we can remove, and parsers we can also remove. So let's start a watcher. Okay, so compute fails. So okay, so what do I want to do? Finite state machine. Let's see. We will go character by character, and the app will stay in one of few possible states. So state is start, the beginning, we don't have anything. Group, which basically, let's see, let's write it here. Start and character bracket will go into group one, and I wonder whether we will have to think about a sum, probably. Yeah. So sum is zero because the group is not closed yet, and anything else will be what? Error? Probably. So then group n, you can think of n as like nesting, group n, and another bracket will create group what? N plus one, and the sum group and closing bracket will, decrement the nesting and will add n to the sum. Then there's the garbage. So garbage and sum. So we are just basically like remembering what was in the group. And I think whatever else will be an error. So garbage, garbage and sum. So if we do this closing bracket, then we go back to the group. If we do the exclamation mark, we will do ignore next character and whatever else is just garbage. Ignore next will be just whatever character go to garbage. And I think that's our state machine. I hope it's correct. So start group okay. So, input stays the same, parse does nothing, and compute. So, let's just take this here so we can see it and do okay, no. String to list input will let's do list reuse process character and we'll start with start. Get answer will be just like get the sum, so maybe get sum So I should have probably done something like maybe integer, but whatever. And we should always finish in a group. So, so we'll say these are incorrect. And now process character. So it will take character and state and give us another state. So if the character is bracket, then go to group. If it's whatever else, we do not have the error state. So further, hello, and this is Elm language, which is kind of looks like Haskell, like PureScript, ML. It's kind of maybe easier for beginners in functional programming to get into. It doesn't have that much stuff going on in it. Simpler syntax and so on. So it's like aims to be nice stuff to do websites with or like cloud applications. So basically improvement over JavaScript. Error. So we'll have to do it here. So I am basically just writing this table here into the real code. So group and plus one sum group and minus one sum plus n garbage, whatever else is an error. Case character of. So here we end the garbage. Here we say to ignore next character. And then ignore next will be just garbage and error. So this should be it. So let's see. Expected zero. Okay, so garbage should give us. Or maybe let's just keep the sum there, but probably not here. Let's see. So garbage. Yeah, so we are in error state right off. So we should allow garbage. Okay, so our test has pa have passed. Passed. I cannot speak English. So Let's bring input down and write it here. And let's just make sure we do not escape from the, you know, from the quotes. So did it already do something? It did, but it went to an error state. Okay, so let's not have an error state. Let's just crash right where we are. And we'll see what happens. Oops. Up. Oops. Okay. So here we are. Group. Some character, and there's no error here. So let's see. Character and to string character here. So okay, yeah, we forgot the what? Column? Is it column? So column should be in a group. So probably group n and sum. I think that makes sense, probably. Okay, so we got an answer. Let's see if it's right. Yeah, that's the right answer. What's my favorite thing about the Elm language? I think probably the, like, these types are awesome because the compiler checks that you have thought about every option. So if I forget a case, it tells me, hey, you have these three, but there's also this one. So, like, do something about it. You know, this goes hand in hand with, like, if in JavaScript you have null, we don't have that in Elm. So if stuff is integer, it's always an integer. It isn't null. And if we want to have maybe integer, we have to say maybe integer, and it's either nothing, which is kind of null, or just the value, which is the value in JavaScript. So, but in JavaScript you don't always do, like, if it's not null, do something. But in Elm, if I want to work with the integer that's inside the variable or value, I have to, there are a few ways to work with it. Either I can do case x of nothing, do something. Case x of just number, or just, you know, then I can do something about it. So it forces me to, like, think about the null cases. So I am really confident in my Elm code that I didn't, you know, forget null somewhere, which for JavaScript developer, it's like heavenly music. So that's one of my favorite things about it. Okay, so I put that back. Yes, I did. Okay, so we've got one star. I don't know, like, why I didn't think of this before. You know, I went 2.5 hours. I was doing like parsers, which I don't understand, and it was not good. And this is a very simple solution. So I'm glad I can get this to work. Further, yeah, it's very similar to Haskell. Sure, I think Haskell is one of the, I guess, main what influences on it. For sure. You know, but Elm doesn't have Thai classes and so on, so it's different. So now you are ready to remove the garbage. Count all the characters within the garbage. They don't count, nor any canceled characters. Okay, so for the completeness sake. Oop. Oh. Interesting. Our test fails even though our code does the right thing. So let's just see. If we do, we are in garbage. And we ignore the closing thing, the closing bracket. We shouldn't get from the garbage to the group. So what's happening? So we are closing the second one. Like this one, sure. Closing this one. So why should it be score of 1 plus 2? So I probably just have the test wrong. Yeah, probably. Okay. Example 14. Similar thing. Yeah, it seems like it. There's something fishy. I don't know. For now, let's just ignore the test. I know that's horrible, but let's just try to do the thing, the second star. So, So we have basically to remember number of integers, no, number of characters we deleted. So let's just use a different process character function, which will not remember the. It will not remember the sum, but the number of, deleted characters. So delete it, and we probably don't even have to think about the number, but it doesn't hurt to keep it there. So, delete it, So if I have this, I don't add anything, but here I do delete plus one. Tests. Okay, something's missing. This is missing. Process character. So I have it twice. Let's give it a different name. Okay, group N 5288. And that's the right answer. Okay, so in the end, it was simple, but I, in the morning, like, 6 hours ago or 8 hours ago, I chose like bad solution, like, bad way to think about it. And it seems the finite state machine is like the way to think about it. In this case, it's really much more simple, much simpler. So, yeah, that's important lesson. Don't make it more complicated than it is, or than it needs to be. So, lesson learned. I will think more about how to solve it before I start to solve it. And before I waste 2.5 hours, doing nothing. So great. Let's just imagine the tests never were there. So let's commit. I think we can get rid of the like the changes to unpackage, which is adding the parser library, which we in the end didn't use. So yeah, that's everything. I'm glad it didn't took that long this time. So with that, I'm going to stop the stream. So have a nice Saturday. I hope that's Saturday for everybody. I don't know about some time zones, but yeah, have a nice weekend, guys and girls.